Dear students, welcome to this lecture on merchandising and export management. In this lecture, I am going to cover the remaining part of the pricing, that is the pricing strategy. Earlier, I have uploaded one video on pricing that covers the various factors which affect the pricing as well as the importance of the pricing. And this lecture is very much related with the earlier one. So the students, you are advised to go through the previous lecture and thereafter please watch this video. So in this lecture, I will discuss the pricing strategy, and out of this pricing strategy, I am going to discuss the basic principle. Next, what are the suitability with the examples and relative merits and demerits. As I have already told you, the pricing strategy will depend on the various factors, and based on these various factors, the marketers select the pricing strategy. No pricing strategy will be ideal for different types of products. That means you cannot expect that the pricing strategy will be always similar for different category of the products. Various factors that we have to take into account. These various factors I have discussed in the earlier video. Now in this lecture, I am only going to discuss what are the various pricing strategy, their basic principle. I will discuss where these are applicable, and lastly, I will discuss what are the relative merits and demerits. Now you know that pricing is a very important, and the pricing we have to process, we have to select in a very systematic manner and a stepwise manner. So let us see what are the steps which are involved in selection of a price of a product. So these are, right now I'm going to discuss what are the steps in setting the price. The first thing is select the pricing objective. In the last lecture, I have told you that organization may have different objectives while setting the price. The organization may want to survive in the market. They want to become the product leader, or they want to maximize their profit, or they want to skim the profit. So there are different objectives of the organization. So first, organization should be sure that what is their objective. After they know what is the objective, what they will do, they will decide who are their target customers and what is the estimated demand. Target customer means they can target the customers who are belong to high income category or low income category, or the target customer may be very much price sensitive. So accordingly, they will select, determine, and they will who are their target customer and determine what is their demand. The next, they will estimate what is the approximate cost of production. Thereafter, they will analyze the price followed by their competitors, and based on that, they will select what is their pricing strategy. That means they can select either penetrative pricing strategy or skimming pricing strategy or competitive pricing strategy, whatever it is. So this we are going to discuss in this lecture, and after selecting the appropriate pricing strategy, they will select the final price. So again, I'm repeating this one. The first, we have to select the price objective. I have told you different organizations have different objectives for pricing. Once they are sure and certain about the what is the pricing objective, they will determine who are their target customer. Are the target customer very much price sensitive? Are they belong to a high income group? Are they belong to a low income group? Thereafter, they will determine what is their demand. Thereafter, they will estimate what is the cost of production. After estimating the cost of production, they will analyze what is the price charged by their competitors. Thereafter, they will select the appropriate pricing strategy, and thereafter, they will select the final pricing. So in this lecture, we will cover this one. What is the appropriate pricing strategy for the product? And I have already told you that there cannot be a single pricing strategy which is appropriate for all category of the product. So there are different pricing strategy, and each and every pricing strategies has their own relative merits and demerits. So these are the various pricing strategy. As you can see from this slide, that cost plus pricing strategy, competitive pricing strategy, value-based pricing strategy, price gaming pricing strategy, penetrating pricing, premium pricing, psychological pricing. And in this lecture, let us see one by one. I will discuss in depth what is the basic principle, what are the scope of application, and what are the relative values that it means. So let us first start with penetration pricing strategy. The penetration pricing strategy, that means here the marketer will keep their price at a very low level. But why they will keep their price at the very low level? Because they want to capture the market, right? And this is especially suitable when they are going to launch a new product in the market. That's why you can say here, and this is suitable for the consumer product, or you can say products which have got a very anticipated life cycle. So you can see here, the price is set to capture market share by entering the market with a low profit as compared with the competition, where compared to the competitors. Okay. And here, the target customers are very much price sensitive. It is believed by them that if they reduce their price, more and more customers will purchase their product. Now let us see what are the advantages. High turnover. See, as the price is low, it is expected that the more and more customer will purchase the product. Next, it is launching for the new product. It is possible to attract large number of customers. And since the production volume is more, it is possible to reduce the overhead cost. Now let us see what are the disadvantages of the pricing strategy. So far we have discussed what are the advantages. Now this pricing strategy has got certain disadvantages. So let us see what are the disadvantages of the pricing strategy. The pricing strategy is very sensitive, okay, because it is believed that why the customer will purchase our product, because the price is low. But there may be yet another competitors who will enter the market with a lower price. So naturally the consumer will shift to that particular product. The margins are sometimes very low because the profit is because the price is set at a very low level. So naturally margins are also very low, and since the margins are low, this company find it very difficult to survive. Next, this strategy never creates a long-term branded loyalty in the mind of the customers. So why it is so? Because the price set is very low. So it will create an image in the mind of the customer that the product may not be of very good. Next is the price expectation. The customers often expect permanently low prices. If the prices gradually increase, customer will become dissatisfied and will stop purchasing the product or service. See, penetrative pricing strategy, here what the marketer do. The marketers, they set the price at very low level, and thereafter they go on increasing the price. But the customer, once they purchase the product at the very low price, they will expect that the product will remain at the very low cost. So once the marketer, they increase their price, the customer will become dissatisfied. And this, as for the reason, the customers are not very loyal to the product. Secondly, it may damage the brand image. As I already told you in the previous lecture also, I have mentioned this thing, because sometimes the price creates the brand image in the mind of the customer. And secondly, it is not a very long-term effective strategy, pricing strategy. And several times, firms may also face a loss of profit. So this is the penetrative pricing strategy. In short, you can say the price is set initially at a very low level, and thereafter the price will be increased further. And this is specially suitable for, as I have already told you, for the determination of the marketing of the new category of the product. So next is the cost plus pricing strategy. Now, cost plus pricing strategy is very simple. Here, what the marketers do, they determine what is the total cost, and over this cost, they will add certain amount of profit. And cost plus profit will give you the total price. As for example, here you can say the material cost is rupees 10, labor cost is 30, overhead cost is 15. So total cost comes around rupees 55. So if we add a markup of 50%, so total price will be, selling price will be 82.50. So what they did, actually the marketers, they determine the total cost and add a profit. So this will give you the total selling price. Now, suitability, when the business organizations are dominant and are price setter in the market. See, cost plus pricing strategy may be simple, but this will not always work. When this will work, when the marketers are the dominant in the market and they are the price setter. The example, we can say the common household goods, durable product, etc. They will come under the cost plus pricing strategy. Now, advantage. The price set by the marketers covers all the cost of production in general. This is very simple and easy way to calculate the price of the product. And this is provides a very consistent rate of return because marketers are adding, determining the price after adding a definite amount of profit. So cost, so it is very much evident from that it will assure a constant rate of return. But as usual, cost plus pricing strategy has also got certain disadvantage. Does not take market conditions into account because price is fixed based on what is the cost and what is the desired profit. The firms may lose sales if the competitor price are not taken into consideration, and sometimes the price set are also very high. Now next, the is the skimming pricing strategy, and the skimming pricing strategy is something quite opposite to that of penetrative pricing strategy that I have discussed earlier. In the penetrative pricing strategy, the price is usually kept at very low level and usually the price is increased thereafter. But in skimming pricing strategy, the reverse strategy is followed. In this case, the price is set at a very high level, then the price is gradually reduced. As for example, these are suitable for the product which have got higher R&D cost. As for example, laptop, mobile, etc. These belong for this, marketers may follow the laptop and mobile. For this, marketers may follow the skimming pricing strategy. Now, let us see what are the advantages. This is possible to recover the research and development cost. Since the price is set as very high level, it is quite possible to recover the research and development cost is very quickly because the profit margin is higher. And the second is that it is the premium exclusive brand image. I have already told you that several times you will find the brand image and the higher price are quite synonymous in some cases. So here, since the price level is very high, it will create a very good brand image. Now, consumer may associate high prices with the high quality and the capabilities. Also, this will create an impression in the mind of the customers that this is of very good quality as the price is higher. But this is also got disadvantage. It is only used for the limited period of time before competition catches up, because it is quite possible that other competitors will come into the market and they will keep the price at the lower level. So when the competitors will keep the price at the lower level, this type of pricing strategy will not be very useful. Then the high prices discourage to the price sensitive customer. Since the price is high, so customers may not appreciate this type of product. But in the case of the penetrative pricing strategy, it was very useful for the price sensitive customer. But unlike penetrative pricing strategies, the skimming pricing strategy is not at all suitable for the price sensitive customer. Next, high prices may encourage the competition to enter the market. And this cannot be applicable in the price sensitive markets. This I have already told you. Next is the premium pricing strategy. Premium pricing strategy, here the price of the product is set higher than the competitors in order to create a favorable image about the product quality in the mind of the customer. That means again that same thing, that is the marketers are following. They try to create an image regarding the product that if the price is set at a higher level, the product quality will also be higher. Now, suitability, this type of price setting is applicable in the products or service provided by the marketers are unique features. See, if the product is differentiated from in the mind of the customer from the regular product which are existing in the market, then and only then pricing strategy will be successful, otherwise not. That means what I mean to say in this case, the marketer can increase their price if and only if the customer perceives their product as a different from the existing one. You can say the Audi, Mercedes, Benz, these are example of premium pricing strategy. So advantage, higher profit margin and better image of the organization. Premium pricing also improve the brand value. This may help to recover the research and development cost at the earliest. Since the price is high, profit is also high, so research and development cost can also be recovered at the earliest. Next is disadvantage. It is depends heavily on the non-price sensitive customer. Because the price is high, so since price sensitive customer will never prefer this type of product. Not possible to sell all products in the mass market. I have already told you that this is suitable only and only if the customers perceive this product as different from the existing market. Now, premium pricing strategy will also fail if the customer comes, if the competitors will produce and sell the same product at the lower prices. Okay. Next is the psychological pricing strategy. You can say the psychological pricing strategy. This psychological pricing strategy, here the marketers play with the psychology of the consumer. As for example, there are different category of the psychological pricing. One is the charm pricing, second one is the prestige pricing, third one is the multiple unit pricing, and fourth one is the buy one get one free. These are very popular in the market and we are all come across this type of pricing. The first is the charm pricing. Here the strategy is often called the charm pricing, involves using the pricing that ends in 9 and 99. With charm pricing, the left digit is reduced from a round number by 1 rupee. As for example, if the instead of keeping the price as 300, the price is kept at 299. Because 299 and 300, though there is a only difference of 1 rupee, the customer will consider, no, it is not 300, but it is in the 299. Next is the prestige pricing. This type of pricing strategy is specially suitable for the luxury items, where the customers are not at all price sensitive. Rather, they consider the price, higher price, as their prestige. So as for example, we can say the jewelry items, branded suits, etc. They always purchase the product if the product price is high, because it's a matter of prestige to them and they want to show their social status. Then is the multiple unit pricing. As for example, 3 for 99 instead of 1 for rupees 33. Basically both are same. But 3 for 99 suggests a bargain and helps increase in the sales volume. Next one is the buy one, get one free. This pricing strategy, once the customer comes across the offer, the logic gets tossed into the wind and the main focus is the market, is the price purchased to get the free item. Okay. Next is the economy pricing. In this type of pricing strategy, the bare minimum price is set to keep the price low to attract the specific segment of the market that is highly price sensitive. Economy pricing means, that means price of the product is set at the very, very low level. Why the price is set as very low level? Because to attract the price sensitive customer. Some of the companies like Walmart, you can say the Aldi, or you can say the IKEA, They are following this type of pricing strategy. Another type of pricing strategy is the captive product pricing strategy. Captive product pricing strategy, it is basically, you can say, let us first define what is the meaning of the word captive product and the core product. Suppose the organization is producing, you can say the printer as well as the ink. These two items are very much related with each other because the printers always needs the ink for the operation. So in this case, what the company will do, they will usually put a higher price on the captive product, okay, and reduce the price on the core product. Okay, that means here you can say the ink of a printer is a captive product and the core product is the printer. So they will reduce the price of the printer, but they may increase the price of the captive product, that is the ink, so that they will like to earn more revenue. So this is the various type of pricing strategy, and what is the most important in the pricing strategy is that you have to understand what is the basic principle of this, and you have to understand what are the relative merits and the scope of application. That means where, which type of pricing strategy will be applicable. So with this, in the pricing, we have covered what is the meaning of the word price, What are the importance of the price? What are the factors which affect the pricing strategy? And lastly, we have discussed what are the step to be followed while determining the price. And lastly, we have discussed what are the pricing strategy and what are the basic concepts, their relative merits and their scope of applications. So with this, we have completed all the market mix. And next and onwards, I will start with the export marketing, right? So, but this slide you can understand even if you will run through the previous lectures on this pricing.